Hey, it's Dr. Berg here. In this video, we're going to talk about the amazing gallbladder, part 3. In part 1, we talked about the function of the gallbladder, and it releases bile to help you break down fats. In part 2, we talked about referred pain and all the different pain sources it can go to that are up in the right shoulder blade and neck and area right here. And then now in part 3, we're going to talk about some additional important functions that you need to know. The other thing that I wanted to mention is that one of the triggers for production of bile is to have a very strong acid in your stomach. If you know anything about pH, when the pH goes down, that's more acid. If it goes up, it's less acid. And so if you go from a pH between 1 and 3, that's like battery acid. It's so strong. And that is the acid that you need in your stomach. When the acid starts going up too high, then like a 4 or 5, you're not going to be able to release the bile from this. And the way that you're going to know that you lose your stomach acids is the valve on top of the stomach that keeps the acid into the stomach will start opening up. They call that GERD. So GERD, really, or acid reflux, is low stomach acids, not high stomach acids. And those low stomach acids are not able to trigger the closure of that valve, and the acid reflux will splash up into the esophagus. So if you have acid reflux or GERD, then we know you're not going to have enough bile. Okay? So that's just an indication to a clue to be able to kind of think with this system and how it works. They're both connected, so you want to understand the whole situation. And just as a side note, one of the most common reasons why people don't have enough stomach acid is they're on low sodium diets. Or salt diets. Sodium chloride. Chloride helps break up to make hydrochloric acid. And if you don't have enough salt, like people are having a low salt diet, your pH becomes more alkaline and you have a lot of digestive problems. So that's as a side note. Okay, now, if this bile is in sufficient amounts, you'll be able to absorb vitamin A. But if you don't have enough bile, your vitamin A deficiency will manifest as night blindness, can't see in the dark. It's difficult to see when the headlights are shining in your eye. Also, your skin will be dry. You'll have all sorts of problems with your skin, little bumps all over the place. And also, the lining of your skin on the inside of your sinuses and your throat will be affected. So laryngitis, sinusitis, any type of lining on the inside of your body is controlled by vitamin A. So here you are taking all this vitamin A, but it's not working because you don't have enough bile, right? You may see, because bile is recycled, you may not have enough because it's not being recycled or it's just not being produced. And so I always recommend to take some purified bile salts to be able to see if that helps you. And if it does, then we know we can start to improve your own body's production. But it's a real simple, inexpensive way to test to see if that is your problem, okay? And again, I'm not diagnosing any diseases here. This is just stuff to think with, so you and your doctor can work together and give them other solutions other than removing this thing. Okay, so we have vitamin A. Also, if you're low in vitamin A, you're going to get acne. I mean, take a look at Accutane. What is Accutane? That's for acne. What is it? It's concentrated vitamin A, but it's in a toxic amount, and that's why there's a lot of side effects. So if you have enough vitamin A, because you don't have enough bile, you probably are not going to get acne. Okay. Vitamin D. Is vitamin D important? Oh my goodness. Vitamin D basically controls the absorption of calcium. And so if you can't absorb calcium, you have all sorts of issues. Calcium is not just bone building, but it has to do with muscle and heart contraction. It has to do with cellular communication. It has to do with improving the immune system. It has a lot to do with a lot of different functions because it's the main mineral that helps communication between the cells. It actually carries hormones between cells. So vitamin D is very important. And so people, a lot of times, they show low vitamin D levels, but it's not because they're not consuming food with vitamin D. It's because they don't have enough bile to absorb it. Yeah. So how do you know if you don't have enough bile? We'll just go down the list. Do I have bloating, burping, belching, constipation? Do I have right shoulder pain? These are just, you know, classic symptoms of low bile. Okay, vitamin D. Now we have vitamin K2. This is a really important vitamin. I talked about it in some of the other videos, but vitamin K2 is different than vitamin K1. Vitamin K2 is a calcium transporter. It basically keeps the calcium out of the soft tissues. Now, if you look at a lot of health conditions, whether you're getting older and you're getting stiffer, you're getting arthritis, hardening of the arteries that's going to cause high blood pressure, strokes because there's calcium plaquing in the brain, cataracts on the eye, that's calcium in the eye, kidney stones, gallstones, spurring, all this extra calcium in the soft tissues, that is because you don't have enough vitamin K. That's why. And so if you're taking vitamin K and you don't see improvement in this calcium issue, it's because you probably don't have enough bile. So you have to think of the things, the cascade effect that can happen. You have to think backwards and see what's before vitamin K2. Vitamin K2 is in all the grass-fed animal products, like grass-fed butter, grass-fed beef, that type of thing. It's in a lot of the things that people are telling you to avoid. They say avoid fat. Well, you need vitamin K2. I take it as a supplement because I have a lot of soft tissue calcium because of my old injuries and the spurring in my back that I had. So I'm using that to help clean that up. But K2 is really important in a lot of conditions, especially if your body's getting stiff and it's turning into a stone. But again, we want to make sure we have enough bile. So soft tissue calcium issues can be caused by a lack of bile. All right? So that's part 3. I'll see you in part 4.